I will never forget my creators, the Magi who refused the great sacrifice, those who would later be branded rebels and traitors. But their intent was not always in opposition. In the beginning, their goal was the same noble objective as Proteus himself: protect Artara at any cost. But where Proteus saw the war with the Arganti all but lost, my creators believed the shadow threat could yet be overcome. They experimented with every means possible to develop the ultimate constructs, artificial beings who followed orders fearlessly with unwavering persistence and unquestioned loyalty, the perfect warriors. While their efforts bore fruit, no construct of Magi design stood superior to the Arganti creations, and each passing day brought the invaders one step closer to Artara's seemingly inevitable conquest. The Magi quickly surmised they would not succeed without aid from the first Magus. In his rage over the Magi's defiance, Proteus erected an impenetrable barrier around his level of the tower, severing all contact with the outside world. Already having failed to breach the barrier themselves, my creators turned to their construct creations. But, like their masters, they too failed. On the verge of conceding defeat, the Magi underwent one last attempt at a new construct. No longer intent on creating a breed of soldiers capable of winning a war, they focused on a single soldier. A construct created for one purpose alone: to break Proteus's barrier. The rebel Magi crafted a construct bound directly to the tower itself, a truly unique meld of magic and technology unlike anything that had come before it. In their crowning achievement, the tower avatar was brought online, and I was eager to fulfill my duty.
While the world was dying around them, Proteus and the remaining Magi devoted all their time and resources to stopping the Organte. Using the remaining reserves of magic power, they extended the tower so it reached the portal, far above ground, for physical contact with the bridge was necessary at the moment of opening. Once the tower was completed, it was the time for great sacrifice. 1,000 remaining Magi did the last thing they could do. First, they purged their bodies of the alien energy, restoring their own original life force. Then, they willingly granted all of this pure essence to Proteus, dying in the process. Their sacrifice created a god, for only a god could oppose such an immense power. And this god looked at the bodies of his friends and family around him and wept, his heart broken with grief. Proteus then ascended the tower, sat in front of the portal on a crystal chair, and waited for its opening. On the other side, he could see a swarm of the Organte waiting to cross over. He could feel their immense hunger. He could hear their obsessive thoughts of destruction, and he despaired. Yet his resolve was strong. He was the last hope for the land, for his people, and perhaps for all the other sentient beings in the galaxy.